We welcome all who have joined us via the live stream. I invite everyone to turn to those around you and greet each other in a spirit of hospitality and welcome. Our presider today is Father Samuel. Please stand and join in singing our entrance hymn, Join in the Dance.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your
spirit. I welcome all of us to this Mass of the second Sunday of Easter, dedicated to divine mercy. We pray for God's abundant mercy in the world today. To prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries worthily, let us acknowledge our sins and ask God for pardon and mercy. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water he has created, which will be sprinkled on us as a memorial of our baptism. May he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. Lord our God, in your mercy, be present to your people's prayers. And for us who recall the wondrous work of our creation and the still greater work of our redemption, graciously bless this water. For you created water to make the fields fruitful and to refresh and cleanse our bodies. You also made water the instrument of your mercy. For through water, you freed your people from slavery and quenched their thirst in the desert. Through water, the prophets proclaimed the new covenant you were to enter upon with the human race. And last of all, through water, which Christ made holy in the Jordan, you have renewed our corrupted nature in the birth of regeneration. Therefore, may this water be for us a memorial of the baptism we have received, and grant that we may share in the gladness of our brothers and sisters who at Easter have received their baptism through Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, cleanse us of our sins, and through the celebration of this Eucharist, make us worthy to share at the table of his kingdom. Amen. Let us glorify the Lord. Let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast kindled the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The whole group of believers was united, heart and soul. No one claimed for his own use anything that he had, as everything they owned was held in common. The apostles continued to testify to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus with great power, and they were all given great respect. None of their members was ever in want, as all those who owned land and houses would sell them and bring the money from them to present to the apostles. It was then distributed to any members who might be in need. The word of the Lord.
Thanks to the Lord for his good. Triumph, his right hand raised me up. I shall not die, I shall live and recount his deeds. I was punished by the Lord, but not doomed to die. The builders rejected has become the cornerstone. This is the work of the Lord, a marvel in our eyes. This day was made by the Lord. We rejoice and are glad. Give thanks to the Lord for we.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Whoever believes that Jesus is the Christ has been begotten by God. And whoever loves the Father that begot him loves the child whom he begets. We can be sure that we love God's children if we love God himself and do what he has commanded us. This is what loving God is, keeping his commandments. And his commandments are not difficult, because anyone who has been begotten by God has already overcome the world. This is the victory over the world, our faith. Who can overcome the world? Only the man who believes that Jesus is the Son of God, Jesus Christ, who came by water and blood, not with water only, but with water and blood, with the Spirit as another witness, since the Spirit is the truth. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. In the evening of that same day, the first day of the week, the doors were closed in the room where the disciples were, for fear of the Jews. Jesus came and stood among them. He said to them, "Peace be with you." And he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples were filled with joy when they saw the Lord. And he said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father sent me, so I am sending you." After saying this, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. For those whose sins you forgive, they are forgiven. For those whose sins you retain, they are retained." Thomas, called the twin, who was one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. When the disciples said, "We have seen the Lord," he answered, "Unless I see the holes that the nails have made in his hands and can put my finger in the holes that they've made, and unless I can put my hand into his side, I refuse to believe." 8 days later, the disciples were in the house again, and Thomas was with them. The doors were closed, but Jesus came in and stood among them. "Peace be with you," he said. Then he spoke to Thomas, "Put your finger here. Look, here are my hands. Give me your hand. Put it into my side. Doubt no longer, but believe." Thomas replied, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "You believe because you can see me. Happy are those who have not seen and yet believe." There were many other signs that Jesus worked and the disciples saw, but they are not recorded in this book. These are recorded so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing this, you may have life through his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord
Jesus. Dear friends, as we celebrate the Mass of the second Sunday of Easter, which happened to be dedicated to the Divine Mercy, let us reflect today on the message of peace, forgiveness, and reconciliation. After the death of Jesus, his passion and burial, his disciples went into hiding for the fear of the Jews. As recorded in the Gospel today, Jesus appeared to them. He already knew what their fears was. He already knew that they were troubled, and he has to show them that he is still with them. He gave them the first gift, which was very important: peace. He said, "Peace be with you," because he knew that at that moment, this is what is lacking in these people. And even today, the world needs peace. Our church community needs peace. Even as individuals, we need peace. to calm our fears and to be ready to be disciples of Christ. He did not only give them peace, he also bestowed an authority upon them to forgive sin. So this shows the central role of forgiveness and peace in the life of the church today. The church always preaches about peace, forgiveness, and reconciliation. By giving them peace already, he is challenging them to come out of their hiding, to come out and embrace the mission that is facing them. He made them new creatures. He recreated them. He made them strong again and courageous people to move. And after that, having prepared them by giving them this gift of peace, he now commissioned them to move. He said, I send you as my Father has sent me. Before then, he knew that sending them may not be easy without giving them something to work with. He authorized them by breathing into them the gift of the Holy Spirit. He said, now go and preach peace. Go and preach forgiveness. Go and reconcile the world to God again. That's why he said to them, receive the Holy Spirit. Whoever sin, you forgive, they are forgiven. Whoever sins, you return, they are returned. And by that so doing, he instituted the sacrament of reconciliation, which is one of the sacraments we have in the church today. And this sacrament today is also seen as a sacrament of mercy as we celebrate the Divine Mercy Sunday today. So, dear friends, for the mission of peace, for the mission of forgiveness, for the mission of reconciliation, it must start within us. It must start in our church communities. It must start in our families. We must try to make ourselves available for God, to be an instrument of this peace. As St. Francis of Assisi would say, Lord, make me an instrument of peace. We must be an instrument of peace. We must be there to reconcile people to God. We must be there to preach about unity. And we must be there to preach about God's mercy, which is always everlasting. We must make ourselves available to resolve conflicts where there is trouble, to bring peace where people are troubled. We must be a bridge over turbulent waters. It's our call, not only for disciples, but for all of us. Just like the first reading, the church community came together. They lived in peace. They preach about common good. And today, we are also asked to be people who preach about common good, who live in unity, who live in peace. We must also try to be apostles of mercy to the world, to give out mercy, to show mercy to people. Little wonder, in the scriptures, Jesus said, blessed are the merciful, for they shall be shown mercy. He also said, blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called children of God. So on a day like this, let us remind ourselves the importance of peace, the importance of forgiveness, and the importance of reconciliation. For our world to know peace, for our world to know justice, for our world to be good again, it is a work for me, a work for you to do. Let us today through the message of today, reconcile the world to God. Prepare ourselves for this mission. Finally, I wish to use the words of a famous singer, Michael Jackson, who says, and I said to, let us go and heal the world. Make it a better place for you and for me and for the entire human race. May we stand to profess our faith. I believe in God. Dear friends, after greeting them with peace, the risen Lord sent his disciples forth on a mission of forgiveness. Let us commend our world to the mercy and goodness of God.
We pray for Pope Francis, Bishop Michael, and all ministers of the gospel, that they will be apostles of peace and reconciliation in our world. Lord, hear us. We pray for a worldwide revolution of mercy, that past and present arguments will be replaced by a commitment to forgiveness and healing. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for chaplains and pastoral carers in hospitals, aged care facilities and nursing homes, that they will be gracious ministers of God's loving kindness for all. Lord, hear us. We pray for our parish communities that the Feast of the Annunciation on 8th of April will inspire us to follow Mary and give an unreserved yes to God's invitation to love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the recently deceased and for all those whose anniversary of death occurs around this time, that they will be blessed with the eternal life promised us by Jesus. Lord, hear us.
God of everlasting peace, by the cross of Christ you conquered death and restored us to life. Help us bring your mercy, forgiveness, and peace to the world. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Jesus is Lord of all the earth.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness I receive this bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, and oak of human hands, it become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness I receive this wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it become our spiritual drink. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, to the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people and of those you have brought to new life, that renewed by confessions of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously. When Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed, for he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exult in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which is poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ will be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Michael our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, Saint Joseph and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from
evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace.
Take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every. Let us pray. Grant to pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts through Christ our Lord. May we sit for a moment.
Just the one announcement this week. Changes in Mass locations. St. Joseph's Cathedral will be closed for 4 days this week so that electrical work can be carried out. So there will be no Masses at the Cathedral on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday or Thursday this week. The times and locations of Masses this week are in the parish bulletin, which you can pick up today, and on the Rockhampton Catholic Parishes website. Thank you.
Thank you everyone for your active participation in this Mass. Thank you Father John. Thank you Joey. Thank you the choir, ministers of communion, and those who read for us today. May we stand. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessings. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessings. Amen. May he by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance. Amen. And may you have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven. Amen. And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you both now and forevermore. Amen. Go forth, this Mass is ended. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Have a wonderful Sunday.